Hello. Hi, everyone. It's Janet again. Janet from Wimbledon, Southwest London. Don't mind the noises, my nephew is. You know. Okay, I don't know. It's just that it's so good to see all of you again. And a little disclaimer here of usually my name is Janet again from Southwest London in Wimbledon. And I just basically wanted to tell you the little disclaimer here. Everything you hear from this video has been in the public domain. I do my own research and I'm very objective, and that's that. I've worked in the public and private sector. I'm trying to do a short-term psychology course, and I have a legal background. So if you want to have any social issues, not just about natural hair day, I also do a bit of basic cooking to help people with their independence and so on and so forth. So I talk about film, books, cinema, theater. Basically, I talk about bereavement, psychology, emotional matters. Not very serious deep depression. I would advise you to go to a therapist. So I don't claim to be a dermatologist or psychologist or anything. I also talk about weight loss journey, fitness and nutrition. I'm not a professional nutritionist or fitness person, but I have had personal trainers in the past, and I've taken their tools and worked with the tools which have worked for me. If I life-changing event, bereavement, if you want to talk about bereavement and so on, it's got nothing to do with COVID. COVID brought that back, and things that I'd gone out and so on. No, so much. No, you don't need to see me. Hello? No, I can talk to you when I'm videoing it. People do that a lot. It doesn't matter. You don't need to, you wouldn't come out on the, you know. Yeah, you can just stand there and ask me a question and I'll answer, because a lot of people do that on YouTube. Yeah, so this yeah, what I would do. Sorry about that. I just, a lot of people go on YouTube and they have you know, they have conversations with other people, and I'm basically trying to tell my sister that she can ask me any question she wants and all that, and it doesn't matter. You know. Okay, so yeah, this is a new background for me. I was trying to open my window because I've got my plants and everything over there, which is just wonderful. I think I've got one more plant here, which is wonderful. I do love my plants. This is usually on the window ledge, but we don't have that much sun, but still the light out there is really disturbing the video, which is strange because we need light. So maybe one day I'll put a bit of the fake light on as well. Yeah, so this is what I do. So even though I'm not a personal fitness nutrition, I do talk about that. And during lockdown, I did lose weight for a while, and then I put on a bit and I got tired. So I found an exercise regime that was good for me. But at the end of the day, I'm not going to talk about it now because I really want to check things for a whole year. Now, you are going to see my previous video to tell you the different image that I've had from the late 90s, early 2000 to 2015 till now. You can see the way I looked in 2015 is the same as the way I looked in the early millennium, late 90s, because I had lost weight. So basically, and that's the different stuff, and I did talk about that. Okay, so I'm gonna talk about the review of my day out, which I thought that it was wonderful. It was okay. And but I wanted to explain to a lot of people who go out with relatives and things, whereby you want to do this, you don't want to do this. I personally believe that when you go to Windsor Castle, Windsor Great Park, or Eton Riverside, or Eton High Street, where you have the Eton private boys who have been there for centuries and all that, or when you go to Oxford and things like that, I do feel that you should take your time and look around the town and so on. And when you go to the Windsor Park, what I was trying to say in my previous video is that you don't have to get all the way to the end, as opposed to where your day out should be a day out and not part of your fitness regime. If you can put a little bit of fitness in it, then that's fine. But I don't think it should be part of your proper fitness routine, okay? And the difference, I felt a little bit, not emotional, like, but I'm not let down, but just different. Whereby my four-year-old nephew was able to go to the end and come back, and he was still, you know. And 10 years ago, I was able to do that and come back and look around. And I just said, if I was ever going to do Windsor again, I would rather just go around the town. You know, you can ask me questions if you want to ask me anything you want to say. Bye bye. Okay, thanks. Okay, I would rather just, you know, go around the town and look at what I'm doing and, you know, I'll be good to go and so on. I don't know if I should keep using this background. This is it. It's not bad. This is my bedroom now. I feel temporarily in my bedroom because my sister and my nephew are staying for a little while. And I've given her the living room. I'm liking this background. I mean, she's so wonderful. She's feng shui in my whole room. She's helped me rearrange my room. And because to me, God, tidying my room and my living room is like, oh, I don't want to go there. Only my bathroom and my kitchen gets tidied. I just have paperwork every day. So she moved everything around and it's just wonderful. I just thought that the curtains would be open and I would have my plants, but even though the sun is not out that much, the natural light from the window is still, you know, really coming in here. I don't know why. I honestly don't know. I feel I should be using the natural light, but maybe in my next video, maybe I should put the unnatural light as well. You know, so there you go. I know some of you are seeing some of my hair products here now. You know, so basically, yeah, this is it. This is a new background for me. I'm filming in my room for the reasons I mentioned. And, you know, it's a bit different. It's not like sort of like a posh house. It's just a basic home in London. It's not really like, you know, people on YouTube, they have this nice design in their home, and some of them, it's not really their real home. It's their real home, then, you know, I'm happy for them and all that. But my parents and my entire family, we downsized a long time ago. My parents had 2 properties in London, had properties abroad. As time goes on, you know, they have to downsize and stay in a 2-bedroom place, and everyone's gonna move out and get their own place. So basically, if you want to talk about change and so on, but I like my change. I don't really need to be in a very big house and, you know, and things like that. So there you go. So anyway, what I was feeling the other day, even though it was a great day out, I was feeling that the last time I did that long walk, I felt wonderful. I suppose that if I was in Buckingham Park or Hyde Park, now Hyde Park and Wimbledon Common Park, remember, Wimbledon Common is the park at Wimbledon Village. It's different from Wimbledon Park. I can walk around, and I can walk from Hyde Park to Hyde Park Corner, where you have the Albert Museum, or where you have that concert where they do the Legions ceremony and all kinds of concerts and all that and so on, and Hyde Park Corner and all that. I can do that from inside or outside the park, and I can walk around Hyde Park, and you can get into the gardens of Kensington, even if you don't want to pay to get into the building. In Windsor, the whole Windsor Park is closed, maybe until they start bringing in people and you have to pay for that. So all you have, I mean, the Windsor Castle is closed. You will see the castle only from the park. What I'm saying is that if you get to halfway in the park, then that's enough, and then just keep walking around. But to start to get right to the very end, from that end you can see Heathrow Airport. That end is where you have King George's statue. That to me is an hour's walk and back. And by the time I came back, I was that tired. Now, don't get me wrong, I'm into fitness and blah 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 blah. Now, if you see my previous video, it will show you the different photos and previews I had. I haven't shown another photo. I think I may have shown you some time ago when I was standing next to the Golden Bus. So I'm not gonna talk about that now. I'm not gonna show you now. So I've always been skinny all my life. And then, you know, sometimes when you hit your 30s, you put on a little bit of weight. 2015, I'd gone down. But my parents passed 2015 and 2016, and I was already moving a month before my mother passed. And she was already in her own place, and I was already due to get to my own place. So, you know, there was just a lot of stuff. And then moving and having to deal with the finance of this place. And, you know, luckily it's a very budget place. It's not very expensive, but still, you know, you're dealing with taking time away, rushing back to work, and then taking time away from work because you're on a career break. Because, you know, sometimes bereavement, you know, you react to bereavement in different ways and so on. So a lot of stuff has gone on, but I think I'm really settled here now. But it's pretty much a small place, but it's just wonderful, you know. It's just wonderful being here. So I just thought, I've had it before. I visited Oxford, Guildford, and all these places, and I always go for like within my house is long walk, but I always felt that the window didn't want the long one. The Windsor one, the long one is a little too much, and you can cut it into half. Now my problem with Windsor Park is that it's a good place to go to, but the park don't have any benches. If you go to Hyde Park in Kensington High Street, you know, if you go to Kensington Palace, you know, if you go to Kensington Palace, it's just next to Hyde Park, you know, you can still walk around. There are benches everywhere, and the kind of person, I'm not the kind of person who wants to sit on what you would call, I'm not the kind of person who wants to sit on the grass. That's not me. That's never been me. Even when I go for a drink, I sit on the bench, the park bench and all that. So I get that in Wimbledon Common, and I get that in Hyde Park. I mean, I have some little, and remember, I'm on the outskirts of Wimbledon, so there's some local parks near me. I'm not feeling there. Somewhere I'll just walk to and come out. But I like the big parks, the royal parks like Hyde Park, and then larger parks like Wimbledon Common and so on, which is what I would have done. But when I did that, there was no time to go to Eaton High Street to do the Eaton boat ride and Riverside and really look around the, you know. So if you're in Windsor Castle or around Windsor Castle or in Windsor, if you're going to walk to that park, please just walk halfway to where you see the cars and come back. There's just no need walking to King George's, you know, it's just ridiculous. There's just no need walking to the end and back because your legs will be so tired. But it was a wonderful day out. Though after that, we went to have fish and chips. I don't know whether it's counterproductive, but we had that, and I had an ice cream after that. And now somebody like me who doesn't take ice cream all the time, my previous video would tell you it's green salad and fruit salad and yogurt, and it's my previous video was saying that. But now and again, you need to give yourself a treat. And my previous video will show how I nearly did 25,000 steps, which is before I left. I'd already done 6,000 steps because I usually do my table and my jumping on the sports and my lifting weights, and I do like a 30 second of a bit of Zumba moves for my 30 seconds for my 1 minute of cardio, because I lift weights more for like 10 minutes. And then the remaining minute is for very quick cardio because I haven't opened my new exercise bag. So I felt that there are a lot of cheap gyms coming out, and there's a new gym near my new, well, my place is really that new. I've been here since 2015 anyway. So I just feel that basically, I don't know, I just feel like when I had to go into Wimbledon Town Centre, it was like a 40-minute walk because I'm on the outskirts of Wimbledon. I no longer live in central Wimbledon. So basically, which wasn't bad, but now I just feel I can just go down the road, and then there's a leisure centre under there. But I don't like swimming, and I don't want to have to go back to a gym whereby I'm doing what, using kettlebells and dumbbells that I already have. There's only one child temporarily visiting me for a little while, and they don't stop me from doing my exercise. I do my exercise in the morning, and I already have my exercise bike. So what I'm really looking for is to just find a dance class in a dance studio, but I'm not sure I want it in a gym because I don't want that, you know, that sort of, you know, because when I took my photo and what I did in Windsor, my friends said, oh my goodness me, look at your arms, you're really lifting weights and da-da-da-da-da-da-da. But my journey is still going on because, I don't know, lockdown, people did put on weight, and I used to be really slim when I was much younger, and now it's kind of like slender, slim, tone, sense, you know, a mix of that. But I'm just going to keep on going with what I do. So it was a nice day out, and it was just fantastic, but I just really want people to understand that you got to take it easy. If you go out for a day out, you go to Brighton, Windsor, Oxford, Cambridge, or you're in the States and you want to go to the coast and all that, you gotta be careful with that. You can have a bricks to 15 to 30 minute walk, but you don't have to have a very long walk because you won't have the energy to do that much, as opposed to a couple of years back when I did it. I was able to do it and felt nothing, and I was wondering whether I should feel emotional about it. I just don't think that I was ready to feel emotional about it, and the reason why I didn't want to feel emotional about it was I wasn't one of those people who was gonna say, oh, you know, I could do this before, now I can't do it anymore, and that type of depression where people feel. But you know what, I'm doing my exercise, I don't smoke, I don't take alcohol. Well, alcohol is the occasional wine, Christmas and birthdays maybe, and I do try my best to you know, I have all the tools I need for my exercise. Personal trainers, I've subscribed to celebrity personal trainers, both online and so on. And sometimes they send messages to me. And, you know, and at the end of the day, in the past, I had a lot of personal trainers. But they actually showed me what happens when you stop going to the gym. I did put on a little bit of weight, but that is understandable. I had a life stream changing within 2 years. My parents had died. This was years before COVID. So this is one of the reasons why I understand why people, I understand why people basically either put on weight or what people are going through with COVID and so on. I will talk about so many different things. So we're getting past 15 minutes. I'm going to leave it at that. The day out was wonderful, but what I'm saying is this is a review on Windsor Castle and eating and so on. And you have to spend the time to enjoy yourself and so on. I was just at least able to wait for my sister to buy a nice toy for my nephew, and that's that. Now, but we could have gone in and out of the shops, but because of that long walk, I couldn't do anything with my legs. Every time I sat down on the bench that was near Windsor Castle, not in the park, which I feel that, you know, I just couldn't get up. And when I get up, I had to make an effort. And by the time we got to Putney, they wanted to try something somewhere which was close. I said, I'm going home. I just hopped on the bus straight towards Wimbledon, because I have to continue towards the outskirts, like towards College Road, outskirts of South Wimbledon, and that's how it's not a problem. But I had to go and have a, and then a cold shower. Although the next day I had to stretch that night, but the next day I was better. But I just feel that anytime I go out on a day, I just cannot afford to overdo it when I go out there. Even if I love my exercise, I want my day out to be enjoyed and put in a bit of exercise in it, but not in a way that my legs will be so tired that I couldn't do anything else. So I'm saying to all of you, that 1 hour that you're using to walk around or walk to the end of that park, that one you could have used 15, 20 for a bricks walk, and then you can go around the stuff, you can go to the River Rhine area and you can do something. But it was a wonderful day, but it's something that I did learn on what I'm going to do anytime I go out. I can't spend too much time walking up a hill and blah blah blah. If you were visiting a town, I'd really like to really enjoy the town and do that, because I already have the weights and lifting. I have my dumbbell, my kettlebell, my exercise bike, my little steps I do. That and a short walk is necessary for me, and it's enough for me. I don't need to do something that my legs become so tired that I can't even enjoy myself for the rest of the day. So you have to be careful. It's a wonderful day out, but be careful when you go on this day out or weekend away. Make sure you just don't do too much, that you can't do anything else. It's really counterproductive, isn't it? Especially if you're somebody like me who's already lifting dumbbells at home and, you know, so on. So this is a review of my time in Windsor Castle, Windsor Park, and eating High Street and eating Riverside. I couldn't even go on a boat or something, but it was wonderful. I would have loved to get into the other shops and just see how things are. Just couldn't do that. So hey ho, well, so that is the review of my day out. And for those of us who can't go abroad and what, I could do them. I've got my passport, didn't I say? Oh, it's not here, is it? Maybe in my next video I'll talk about it. You know, I'm so pleased because I've got my passport and I don't want to get up. So in my next video I will show you the new passport that's got nothing to do with Brexit. It's Brexit out, because we are out.